What's going on? My name's Golly and welcome to the Crash Course. Today we are going to be going really quickly through all the things that basically you're gonna have to know when getting started in the city. So I'm not gonna take up too much of your time because I know you're eager to get started. However, once you spawn in, you get $10 or 10 money in your little green money area. As you can see, I've got 10 for just spawning in right now. And then you've already gone through all this because you're at the video stages. So let's get started. Let's get right into it. So thank you for visiting the YouTube. And let's begin. Let's get right into it. So first thing we're going to need to do is, after leaving the spawn, we're now in Spawn Park and we want to go to the homeless shelter. And the homeless shelter is marked with those green letters that say homeless on it. Now here is where you can get free food. And what you do to get your free food is you go onto this pressure plate and then cookies are going to pop up here. Sometimes you just have to wait a minute. And yeah, there we go, you just have to wait a minute.
Okay, so now that we've got our food, and by the way, there is a grocery store that you can go to, and that's got your, once you make a bit more money, you can actually go out and buy steaks and chickens and stuff like that. So now that we're up here, what we're going to do is we can take a bedroom, and each room comes with a bed and a chest that you put your stuff in, set your spawn, do whatever you'd like.
So now that we've got a place to stay, we've got a bit of food, we want to go start making more money, that way we can buy better food, because if you didn't know this, cookies actually deplete your hunger faster than any other food, other than watermelon. So now we want to get some proper food and maybe get a house or an apartment. So these yellow beacons indicate jobs. What we're going to do here is come to the unemployment centre, or the employment solution centre, which is right next to the homeless shelter, and you go in here to the resume office to get your resume. So you walk in here and then voila, you've got a resume right inside your inventory. And now let's go apply for a job. So with your resume in hand, you're going to want to walk out the back, and there are soon to be more than one job inside the city. I'm only going to demonstrate with one job, but once you find beacons, actually let me head back here for a minute.
Once you see the beacons, you'll know those are jobs that you can take. But really quickly, just take a look at this bulletin over here. So these are all jobs that players in the game are offering, but as you can see here, it says mailroom, and the coordinates up here. So coordinates are 1428, 341, right? A resume required. When you see resume required, or RR, that means it's an automated job that you don't need to rely on actual players to do.
So let's head over. We're going to go across this bridge, all the way down, and then you'll see this tall brown building, and that's where we're going to be working today. We're going to walk in, and here's the address, just as mentioned on the bulletin board, and you can see my coordinates at the top left are all matched up. So we're going to go down the elevator, or these scaffolding here, and we're going to go into the management's office. Now typically what we do is you'd go in here and then you drop your resume into this drawer, and then it would actually teleport you into the mailroom, but it's currently out of order. So if that's still the case while you're playing, simply press this button and here you are inside the mailroom. So to get started here, to operate this job, you're going to push this button, and a cart with a chest is going to go over this chest right here, and we're going to get some mail. So we have mail letter H, so we can see everybody's wee cubbies. But we need to find H, so A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, right here. So you're going to throw your mail into the cubby, and then you're going to push the button. And as you can see in the top, or in the middle, centre right, I've got $12 now. I did start out with 10, and now I've got 12. So just demonstrate that one more time. We've got mail E, throw it into the cubby over here. I notice my money when I push this button. Goes up to 14, and that is essentially how you get your start in the city. Once you've finished your shift, you just push this button, it'll take you out here. Typically it is supposed to teleport you, but again, we're currently having some issues with that, but by the time, well, in some point in time, we'll be able to go over that. So now let's go to the bank. This is another super important part. So we're going to go back over this bridge, alright, over the bridge, and then let's go to where we started, alright? So this is the park that we started at, this is the homeless shelter and the employment solutions. So what we're going to do now, facing the homeless shelter, is turn left. We're going to go all the way down the road. Now we're going to the bank. So to get to the bank, you just go all the way down here, and then you can see it's got green letters that say bank. Now, in order to use the grocery store, we currently have to use cash. We are making it so you can use credit, or the debit, whatever, but we're currently using cash. So what I'd like to do is, I've only got $14. So I'm going to withdraw $1 at a time. So that's what this does. And you click the button once, only once, and then it gives you $1. You click the button again, only once, and it gives you another dollar. The cash is SM dollar bills. That's what we used before we had this implemented. Now you cannot spam this button, because if you do spam this button, what's going to happen is it's only stacks in one. It's not going to give you extra money. So make sure you press the button once, one at a time, right? If we had more money, we could do hit the button once for $32, or we could do hit the button once for $64, but we just don't have that in the budget currently. So the final thing I'm going to show you now is the grocery store. So what we're going to do here is, all the way down, this is facing the homeless shelter, right? We've got the spawn part. So facing the homeless shelter now, we turn right, we go all the way down, and just before you hit the bridge over here, you're going to turn left. And over here, we've got the seaside shell. Now, this is the grocery store, and once you walk in, instructions are given to you by the clerk. It says, welcome to seaside shell. Be sure to put your cash in the top left corner of the chest when making your purchase. So, let's say we want to purchase, I'm thinking about some cream of mushroom soup. This sounds good. So it's only $2. So what we're going to do is take our money here, one, two, place it in, and there you go, you've got your food. And this works for all the food that we've got here in the grocery store, except for the baked goods. Oh no, it does work for the baked goods actually. So yeah, we've got all this. So anyway, that is how you essentially get set up in Dreamdale. You've got your food, your shelter, and how to make money. Thanks for watching, hope this helped out. Make sure you subscribe, like the video, and check out some of the other cool videos that we've got on the channel. Alright, take care and have fun on the server.